dear friends. My name is Kajishwar, and we are gathered here on this fine morning to witness this exciting event. So, dear teachers and friends, lend me your ears as I am about to narrate a story entitled The Kangaskhan Sparrow. In a little house, in a little village, in Japan, there is a little old man and his little old wife. One morning, when the old man sleeps among his friends to drown the sights of the Japanese southwest, she saw on the doorstep a poor little sparrow. She picked him up gently and fed him. Then she held him in the bright morning sunshine until the cold dew was dried from his wings. Afterwards, she let him go so that he might fly home to his nest. But he stayed with her to thank her with his songs. Each morning, when the sun rose near the mountain tops, the sparrow perched on the roof of the house and sang out his joy. Tweet, 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 you are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy. Tweet, 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 tweet. You never know me, how much I love you. So please don't take my sunshine away. The old man and old woman decided it was time to go to work. Across the leaf of old woman, at last she became so angry that she caught the sparrow and cut his tongue. Then the poor little sparrow flew away to his home, but he never could sing again. When the kind woman knew what had happened back, she was very sad. She told her husband, "Let us go and find our poor little sparrow." So they started together and asked of each bird by the wayside. In this way, they followed until they came to a bridge. They did not know which one to take, and as folks could see, no one to ask. At last, they saw Ben heading head downward, taking his daytime nap. "Oh, friend Ben, do you know where the Kangaskhan Sparrow went?" "Yes, over the bridge and up the mountain," said the bear. He blinked his sleepy eyes and was fast asleep again. They went over the bridge and up the mountain. But again, they found two ropes and did not know which one to take. A little field mouse bit through the leaves and grass. They asked him, "Do you know where the Kangaskhan Sparrow went?" "Yes, down the mountains and through the woods," said the field mouse. Down the mountains and through the woods, they went and last came to the home of their little friend. When he saw them coming, the poor little sparrow was very happy indeed. He and his wife and children all came, bowed their head to the ground to show their respect. Then the sparrow rose and led the old man and the old woman into the house, while his wife and children quickly brought them boiled rice, fish and vegetables. After they had their lunch, the sparrow wished to make them enjoy their stay more. So he danced for them the sparrow dance. Geek, geek, geek. When the sun began to sink, the old man and old woman decided it was time to go home. The sparrow brought out two baskets. "I would like to give you one of these," he said. "Which one will you take?" One basket was large and looked very full, while the other one seemed small and light. The old people thought that they would not take the large basket, for it might have all the sparrow's treasure in it. So they said, "The journey home is long, so please let us take the smaller one." They took it and walked up over the bridge and across the mountains, happy and contented. When they reached the started to open the basket to see what the star had given them. Reading the basket, they found rolls of silk and halls of gold, enough to make them rich. So they were more grateful to the sparrow. The lucky old one, when half the sparrow's tongue was peeping through the window, when they opened their basket, she saw all the treasure that the sparrow had given them and planned to get some for herself. The next morning, she went to the kind old people's house and said, "I am so sorry that I cut the tongue of the sparrow. Please tell me the way to so, so that I will go to him and tell him that I'm sorry." The kind old woman told her the way and so she went on the journey. When she reached the sparrow's home, he was not glad to see her, but yet he was kinder and made her feel better. When she was leaving for home, the sparrow brought out two baskets. "I would like to give you one of these." And of course the old woman chose the large one. The basket was very heavy and it was difficult for her to carry all the way home. As soon as she reached home, she quickly opened the basket to see the treasure. Treasure indeed! A swarm of horrible creatures burst out the basket the moment she opened it. They stung her, they beat her, they pushed her and pulled her and scratched her, picked her up